What a glorious day to be king. Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to my In the Name of Jerusalem 2 campaign for Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. Today we are diving back in with episode 3. If you've missed any of the episodes, no need to worry. I'll go and leave a link to the playlist down below in the description where you can find every single episode, those of them which are already out and those are yet to be. If you're watching this in the future, everything will be in that one place. In the previous episodes, we basically went on a rampage in the north, dealing with traitor after traitor after traitor, and that was pretty successful. We destroyed this rebellious lord and then made our way northwards and pretty much destroyed this one. He only has 2 settlements left now. Maybe I should spend some time to conquer these, but I think we'll do that off camera. We've seen too much of the Danube and the north of the Balkans. So I think today, in today's episode, we're going to head down south and probably deal with this rebellion and then maybe start harassing the Normans, try and take back a few of these islands. And then obviously the ideal goal would be to push the Normans back into Italy itself. There is also a lord down here I want to talk to, because that is goal number 2 of this episode, is to get married. Once we're married, we can start holding feasts, and that is a great way to start building up our reputation in the region and with the surrounding lords. It actually wouldn't be a bad idea as well, and I'd be completely down to do it as well, to pick up the assassination mod as well. That could be a really fun thing to actually add into this campaign. Let me know in the comments if I should add this. This is Artem's assassination and like roguery mod. You can basically do a whole wealth of extremely interesting things, like assassinate people, threaten, and tons more. It's a very, very cool mod. I've actually made a video about it on the channel. But yeah, let me know if that's something you guys want to see me add, those of you who know, and those of you who don't. Yeah, just comment down below. But it does look like we have another rebellion, where this time, I mean, it's getting hard to even keep the... Okay, Thessalonica, that's good, because we were about to actually marry into this family, or we were trying to. That's a little bit scary because it is closer to us, but I mean, my god, like, what more can we do to keep the empire together? We might, you know, even look to rebel against ourselves, if we could maybe take a little bit more land. Okay, I am now stocked up on food and water, and we're going to head down south, basically looking to help out in the invasions of the Reconquista of the Greek islands that have, you know, been taken away from us from the Normans. We're going to basically make our way down there through the straits here as we cross over between Asia Minor and the west right there. Nice kind of slipping the knot, and hopefully making planetfall quite quickly. I don't really want to make our way through a lot of these mountains, but we should be fine. We're going to also have to keep a close eye on the rebellious lords here, because they're only a little ways away from us. Luckily, we're quite embedded, so we should be safe, but you know, we'll definitely keep an eye on that, to say the least. We do need to be a little bit careful in the mountains as we progress through enemy territory. As I said, we're basically looking to meet up with this army. It seems like it's currently camping up here. Yeah, we're going to basically meet up with them and hope they go in. They did just recently conquer this. I couldn't make it quite in time. But yeah, we're going to go join up. Again, if this guy wants to let me marry into his family, that would be kind of cool as well. How about that? My own hand? No, he doesn't want to. Okay, fair enough. We'll just join up his army. The nice thing is as well, we get to discover everybody in his army, so that will help. And then, yeah, we'll look to, I guess, see to where to conquer, and it does seem like he is immediately going over. Okay, immediately in. A bit risky because, again, we are just going in with no equipment. It's just going to be a pure brute force battle. Luckily, we were able to starve out the garrison, which is nice. And then after that, we only have 1 settlement left to conquer, which is going to be a perfect. And that's basically this invasion down here in the south. But the main thing, the main reason we're doing this is to build up our own influences. We had a lot of campaigning in the north where we were leading soldiers. And that's kind of, you know, we've paid our pound of flesh there. We've been exhausted and now we need a bit of time to actually recover. Soldier! So now we're going to be okay. I've got commander some archers as well. Of course, I look to utilize that as best as we can. We're going to push our way up. Hopefully, we can kind of conquer this, get into the gate, get the gate open as we don't have a battering ram as quickly as possible. So let's get the archers positioned. I guess I'll get my archers positioned like here. And if we have any javelins as well, I'll be more than happy to utilize them. It does seem like this is quite an experienced army as well. There are a lot of high tier units here. Yeah, look at that. A lot of elite units pushing forward. Lots of javelins as well, which are great for clearing out walls. The ladders are actually already up over here as well. Very nice. And now my archers are in position. We'll make sure they're in loose formation rather than scattered. I always find that they do way more damage here. And they should immediately... The javelins are there as well. Maybe I should get a little bit closer. I also don't want to get too close where the... where the javelins kind of hit into our own units. But we should be in a good position here. I think we're away from all the artillery fire. There's an artillery piece up there. And the archers can just hammer away. So this should get us some good experience through just leading the men. I'm going to dismount, get stuck in here. Generally never normally a great idea, as we've seen in the past. I've generally normally failed here. But if I can get up before they can really form, because it seems like they are slowly moving up, and our archers are hitting them in the side as well. I want to try and get that artillery piece out of commission. Oh my god, look at that. He can turn all the way here. Oh, that is amazing. Let's just get here then. Kill this guy, and then we're going to blitz to it. Because if I can use it against the enemy, oh, that's going to be amazing. First things first, though, of course, we just need to not die. And taking that much damage is fine. These axes don't really do much. Now let's get up here. There's some javelins here as well. I'm going to take both of these because that could lend us to some easy kills up here. Oh, I've actually already dead from my archers. Perfect. And now we can launch us against the enemy. Oh, it's going to be amazing. Okay. Okay, I don't want a friendly fire, but let's try that. A bit of friendly fire. Okay, I probably did more friendly fire than not. But did that also give us engineering as well? No, just tactics. Okay, I'm fine with that. Let's get another piece loaded. And we could probably even use it maybe against the gate or up there. That's really cool that you can use this against the defenders. Okay, loaded it ourselves again. They're already broken through there, but I don't think... Oh, that's as far as it can go. Fuck it, let's go. I mean, we are killing enemy units, but I'm also killing a lot of friendly units as well. That has to be them dealt with, though. Let's push back down. I don't think I'm going to... Are you friend or foe? You're friendly, right? Yeah, you're friendly, just helping out. That's fine. And then we'll just come up here. Are you friend or foe? Friend or foe? Yeah, friend. Okay, okay. Okay, let's push up now. I think we've cleared this section out completely. Perfect. The archers. My archers, that's what I'm saying. My archers are well positioned. Let's try and make sure we take care of this catapult. Pull out our sword now. Slice him down. Pull out our... javelin again. I love how the javelins are also positioned like in your shield as well. Such a cool way of holding them. I really, really like that. Let's go for a headshot here. Not quite a headshot, but still right to the heart. Need to avoid this. There's a lot of archers there. Just keep that shield up. And just make our way up here. Always be careful there. To block the arrows as well. Let's make our way around the corner. Kind of need a little bit more support here. Smash away here. Couldn't quite get the strike off. Stabbed him in the back though. He's a little bit faster than me. Wow. All my heavy armor slowing me down. Okay, now let's make our way after the archers. I think we'll be fine here. Until we're not. Oh, there's archers behind me as well. Okay, not good, not good. I've got too much heavy armor on though. The lighter armor is obviously helping them out. Keep that blocking. Getting shot on the side as well. Yeah, I really do swing this sword very slowly in my heavy armor. And the archers as well. Okay, this is not good. I love this fight. Like, the lighter infantry are able to swing. They're not doing much damage, but they're able to swing that a little bit faster. I'm going to go down. Maybe try and get the gate open. It's another one down. Perfect. Okay, let's get the gate open. Okay, gate is open. And now they should be sending men to try and close it. So we're going to pretty much just stand here. Yeah, and deal with these guys making their way over. Our swings are a little bit faster. That's about it. The stabs are a bit different. I don't know how much longer I can keep this gate open. I'm trying my hardest. It helps when they're not defending. Okay, one more. Okay, let's want that guy taken care of. Don't close it. Before I get, I'm getting shot from up there as well. Okay, another one. We're at least getting some one-handed skill here. Okay, you're going to take care of him, which is going to be good. Don't let that gate get closed. We should be good, honestly. We should be good. Yeah, annoyingly, I've defended the gate, but it doesn't seem like anyone's coming through. So I'm just going to leave this. The boys are obviously clearly stuck elsewhere. Let's make our way back into this turret, I think. Yeah, let's deal with these archers again. We're back to where we were. Let's deal with some of these guys. We can knock them down, which is going to be really funny. Besides that guy. Oh, I really wanted to knock them down. Oh, that's just annoying. Let's deal with him. That's him dealt with. Shield back up. We are very close to going down. I'm not going to be able to get them. So let's pull back, pull back. Yeah, that's a bit too much. I wanted to... Oh my god, there's so many archers here as well. Oh my god. Are we not breaching the walls yet? Come on. One shot and we're dead. Yeah, okay, here you go. Yeah, you guys are still like pushing here. I mean, but now they're just making their way through. But we were stuck here for a while, wow. Yeah, now we're bulldozing through. Seems like I may have been a little bit too ambitious. But this is all RBM, like soldiers do hold their own. You know, they put up their shield, they try and push forward slowly, and that weight of numbers really does make a big difference. Right now we're utilizing it. But a handful of men can hold the position if it's not cleared, you know, quite effectively. Let's try and clear this out as much as we can. Again, try and drag the enemy off so we can get more men in. Yeah, ideally, I want to just drag all of these guys down here so that the boys are mainly in. Hit him with our shield. Slash there as well. Perfect. Okay, there we go. I think we're already attacking the other side. I really wonder why we haven't been able to push the other side, if that makes sense. You know, where we came from. Because I cleared that a long time ago. The boys just stuck there or something? They must be, right? Because we cleared that a long, long time ago. Take a look. Yeah, I guess they're stuck. I don't know. They're running this way. I don't know what happened there, why they couldn't push through, because as we saw, like, I took that a while ago. They must have just been stuck, I guess. So another castle has been claimed, which is perfect. The rebels down here only have one settlement left until they basically get starved out, which should probably provide us with a good bonus. I'm not sure if I can, like, mark this and we'll go towards it. Hopefully that is the case, as we clearly have enough soldiers to do so. And we only actually have 400 men now. Isn't that much? Oh, it does seem like as well that we maybe leveled up, which we did, which is nice. Where would I like to stick my points? Is anybody else leveled up as well? Or at least close to? No, it doesn't like you have. Maria hasn't quite yet, and Imad hasn't either. That's fine, though. We have. So we either stick more points in leadership, which is, you know, gives you great bonuses. We can stick another point in stewardship to continue to progress that. And honestly, getting more or engineering might not be a bad idea. So yeah, let's maybe just go ahead and stick another intellect point. The other one would be putting it in bigger. But I think this is fine. I think maybe having a better, you know, kind of search up, because ideally we want to get to this. This is like one of the best perks in all of stewardship. So the sooner we get that, the better. Oh, it looks like we are leaving the rebellion down here. That's kind of annoying. Why? Do we need to go to a... Oh, we're probably going to a city? No, I think we are actually just straight up chasing enemies. And now we are heading to a village to recruit. Oh, we went back to recruit 59 recruits. Wow. That village must have been stocked up. So most of our armies are actually heading back north, I guess. Oh, yeah, they're conquering this. They conquered this and the rebellion there only has one left. So I would actually love to maybe produce an army myself to deal with the rebels to the south. We are losing this, it seems, probably to the Serbians. I would love to finish these guys, because once they're done, then we only have one rebellion left unless more spawn or one major rebellion. I wouldn't say anything down here is too much to worry about. So yeah, let's maybe raise an army ourselves. We'll go distance and see if anyone's a 2 days. These guys are pretty expensive. Yeah, I guess just that should be enough, right? And we could even head home to recruit some more men. However, we are on campaign, so maybe I recruit all my prisoners. Again, because we're fighting rebellions, these are all our type of soldiers. That'll boost me to, what, 82 men? We lose a bit of stuff, but nothing too worrisome. Probably do need to buy some more food, though, whilst we're here. Especially the water. We'll take the grain and the grapes and the cheese as well. Keep our food stocks high. And let's head back. Let's head back to friendly territory. Could even head off to Crete whilst we're here. Literally, when will it end? When will this hatred end? We might have to rebel and take our own kingdom at some point, you know? I mean, where was it this time? Where was it this time? So Thessalonica was last time. Is there anyone important? Because it's only a small count. I don't really care. Oh, it was back over here again. So we had another rebellion there. Yeah, I mean, if we can't... But you know the thing is, we can't pillage the city, so we can't, like, ruin them and be like, yo, don't ever rebel again. Also waiting for the rest of the army to finally show up. We can. There is a tournament here, so let's just go ahead and dive into it. We might as well. I have wanted to win a tournament for some time, so this could be the perfect opportunity. Emma seemingly is a good mace there. We'll take some of our strongest cavalry with us. It is just a 2v2 tournament. I need to remember that it's not the top two teams that go through. It is going to be, you know, the best of ones.